Hello friends, we were seeing the topic life processes. So life processes means the basic functions performed by a living organism to maintain their life on earth. That means that make keep them themselves alive. So for that there are some of the characteristics of the living organisms which we are seeing. And in last session we have seen that living organisms obtain and use energy for what? For their growth, development, repair, as well as for reproduction. For every you can say basic functions, for the performance of every basic functions of living organisms, they need energy, and this energy is metabolized in the body of organisms with the help of the chemical reactions that are taking place in the organism. Now catabolism, anabolism and catabolism makes up the metabolism. So now let's see first of all what is anabolism. Anabolism means conversion of complex substances into simpler ones. Okay, you can take the examples of photosynthesis, in which what happens, the CO2 gas is converted into glucose in the plants. So that means the, you can say, from simple substances the complex substances are formed. Okay, right, from simple substances complex substances are formed, that is anabolism. Okay, and now in catabolism what happens is that complex substances are converted into simpler substances. Like example can be digestion. That means when you eat food, that food is converted into the small molecules. Okay, it start in your mouth itself. Okay, the food is when you chew the food, it is converted into, you can say, it is bitten up and it is converted into small molecules. After that it goes into your stomach and again the digestion starts. So that is an example of conversion of food from complex to simple substance. So these both processes make up the metabolism, finally releases the energy. Okay, now all organisms maintain homeostasis. Homeostasis means a stable condition of a body which is necessary for life. That means optimum temperature, your body temperature is normally 37 degrees Celsius, right, plus the water, you can say blood volume, pH balance, water balance, that has to be at an optimum, you can say, level. And that optimal level which is maintained by the living organism is called nothing but homeostasis, right. Now living organisms have hereditary traits. That means what happened, our body contains genes, right. So these genes are transferred from parents to their children, and that's why the children resemble as their parents, because hereditary traits, that means some of the genes which are carried from parents to children, that means some DNA is transferred from parent to the children. Due to this, the hereditary characters are transferred. Okay, and mutations change DNA code and they are passed from generation to generation. That means if the DNA code is changed, that means DNA code is changed, that means mutations takes place, and these some of the traits are transferred from one generation to another. So in this session we have seen some of the characteristics of living organisms. In next session we will see what is the role of nutrition in living things. Okay, thank you.